they're perfectly capable of playing pressure defense. I think Vanderbilt should play solid defense, but not extend too much.
Butler defended by the smaller Howard. Butler with the runner.
Two shots from 3 feet already for UConn.
Perron Butler hit in double figures in all but one game as a freshman last year, and he finishes on Howard, and Kevin Stallings wants to talk things over. 65 seconds in, he wants to discuss things. He does not like the way the UConn's been able to get the transition game going. Vandy 0 for 6 from the floor in the early going. Brown to the cutter, Butler. Butler with a great cut to the hoop without the ball. Plays long for a guy 6'7", doesn't he?
He really does. He's got a nose for it.
Look at Butler pick a pocket. This young man was 6th in the Big East in steals last year.
And he's got 3 already in this game. And he's done it 3 separate ways. That was an anticipation play on a pass out in the lane. Last time he stole it off his own man when he made a pass.
He had...
There we go again.
Steals. This is incredible. 4 steals for Butler in the first 5.5. And Kevin Stallings' Commodores are shell-shocked. Pashevsky twice.
Okafor, impressive, Bob.
And Butler runs the floor and is rewarded.
UConn standing around against the zone right now.
Brown in the lane, pick out Butler.
That's what you want. First and varsity team second. Times have changed, so you don't see what we're talking about very often right now.
Gordon missing the shot and Butler with the putback. Second foul on Hundley, 6 on Vanderbilt this half. Butler for 3. 19 points.
Robertson hesitant to pass the ball to Gordon, who's wide open twice.
Gordon wide open again. Rebound. Butler takes it right away from Freegi.
That is a man.
That UConn Huskies website looks pretty good, too.
Klavik misses the shot, and Okafor with his 12th rebound. UConn up 16, and we mentioned the Bees at the beginning of the broadcast. They combine again. Brown feeding Butler for his 22nd and 23rd points of the night.
Play up tempo. That's our game. If it doesn't work, so be it. That was a walk. Perron Butler gets the 2, a sophomore from Racine, Wisconsin. Butler is there for the follow-in.
And this is going to be a recurring problem for GW.
Monroe, he does penetrate, but he's not having much success. He's hit a couple of field goals. A
lot of help coming every time he does penetrate.
Off the glass and in, Butler.
That was either a walk or a foul. And Tom East decided to swallow his whistle there.
Butler knocks one down, and Karan Butler, a legitimate All-American, has 8 points.
And Temple, if they had lost that game, would not have been in the NCAA tournament.
Nearly a steal. Butler's jumper. Oh, off the glass.
Bang,
hit it.
People who read my stuff think I should have been a coach. And a lot of people who've seen me coach think I should keep riding.
Nice slam inside.
Robertson. To Butler with 15 on the shot. A tough shot. Fades and scores. Wow, that was a clean
up on him, right?
A lead gift. Q lost it going up. Brown takes it. Takes over, wins the battle, and he's got help. Power move. Gave it up right, and how he squared up. Magnificent. Turn your back to the defender. Get parallel. Connecticut in the lead. UMass is close to within 4. Butler got it. Big time play. Big time player. Get 13.
A little bit of a dagger there.
Off the offensive glass and a fresh 30 on the shot clock. Inside Butler for his first field goal of the night.
That's where he's done a lot. This was really a tempo situation, a little 2-2-1 three-quarter court.
Butler left side jumper. He's got all 5 of the Huskies' points. Rebound pulled down by Selby, his 7th. Quickly, Butler picked up the 2 quick ones in the first half, and he picks up where he left off when he was in the game. He's got 7 points, rebounds, 3 block shots, and no personal fouls. Robertson kick out, Butler for 3. And Perron Butler has reached double figures for the 35th time, and this his 36th career game. A 3rd-team All-Big East selection. Butler cuts without the ball, and Selby rewards him.
Yeah. Connecticut doing a pretty good job, and Romano just forced him on the block.
Gordon. Oh. Had nowhere to go, but there's Butler with the putback.
Wow. Just great pursuit of the basketball. He was in transition. He was one of the last guys up the floor, but watch where he goes. He's going to come from the right elbow, come right down the middle. And Mims, nowhere to be found. Bishop reacting late. Long arms. That wingspan helps him defensively and get boards. Look at that span. Go up with it and the strength to take a hit. And yes, sir. We see you, Mr. Butler.
Man was coached by Jim Boeheim. And speaking of Coach Boeheim, glad to see him back on the Syracuse bench last night. Butler with following up his own miss.
As they keep switching these defenses up just enough to confuse. That time they went back into his own.
Stolen away by Butler.
Uh-oh. An
what a move. That should get the place going. Holy cow.
That's going enough.
Ball.
But with the emergence of Marcus Barnes as an offensive threat, that has cut his time down. Right. Butler works his way to the baseline and bangs it off the glass.
See, that's what Jim Calhoun is hoping for. Butler
to Robertson. And now Butler in the lane, leans back and buries it.
That's a beautiful move also, because just in the middle of that sequence, John, he lost control of the basketball, but he's such a great player that he was able to compose himself and get back under control. He comes around this corner real well. Just right there, he loses the ball, almost travels, but strong enough and really experienced enough to get that shot off with a little bit of a drift.
Great set man-to-man right now for Miami.
Got a screen from Okafor and puts the Huskies on top. 9 points for Butler. UConn has the lead. Three and two Huskies. Butler off the glass. Blocking foul. Count the basket.
How about the stop on a dime by Butler on the break? A good recognition on when you have to go straight up and shoot the basketball. Once again, bad shot for Miami's end. Up straight, a little bit of a slide under just then. Good finish, too, by Butler to complete the play.
Huskies trying to end the 14-game winning streak of Miami. Butler, as the clock runs down, buries the three.
Test the waters underneath first.
14 points now for Jones. He is over his season average. Here's Butler.
Nope, that's a walk. Got away with it.
And he got the basket. That's 18 points now for Carrado.
Very difficult matchup. And again, once these Sooners elevate, you really can't contest the shot.
He's broken out of his slump. A nice line drive shot off the glass by Brian Butler. Did it twice in the first half. Butler face-up jumper's good. He got the hot hand, too. Brian Butler with 16.
And this quick Oklahoma D hasn't presented too many opportunities.
Sure enough. Butler steps out, drills the three.
Now, if you want to move Karan Butler to the backcourt.
Position. That's the case that Kelvin's pleading. Karan Butler, quick release, got the roll.
Quick and soft. Karan wants to get as the first option.
16 on the shot clock, under a minute to play. Talik Brown inside. Put it up. He missed it. Selby, Okafor's got it. Here's Karan. 67, first tie, 6-6-6.
Better late than never.
At court, when the coach was upset with rebounding, most of the breakdowns have come from the back court. UConn's guards not keeping people off the boards.
There is a big league play as Karan Butler loses the defense. 11 points a game, a sophomore from Baltimore.
Boy, he had his tonsils checked on that one, too. That was good D.
Butler fires again, so Karan Butler lighting it up early with consecutive jump shots, and he brings the Huskies back to within one. Tony Robertson. Butler fires the ball and knocks another one down. Andrew Sullivan's all over him, Bucky, but to no avail.
Well, the key now, after hitting those three, you got to make there's another.
Justin Brown comes up with a loose ball, gets it up quickly. Karan Butler all the way down. Man alive. We have man against boys out here at the moment as Karan Butler, he loses it. You'd like to say, Bucky, stick a fork in it. It's all over the floor. And now the ball comes down low, and Karan Butler breaks his 0-for-5 streak with an inside hoop.
Is trying to check Ben Gordon, who is quick on quick. Look for Gordon to go at him. Can't believe he's not.
Loop to Okafor, and Okafor again works to the basket. That's the lead to six. Back the other way, and there's Caron Butler down low. Answering quickly for the Connecticut Huskies.
So far, Mark, Providence just settling for the threes.
And you have to be very wary of shooting only threes. It leads to quick opportunities for Connecticut.
Like there.
That opens up lanes for Linehan to get in and penetrate.
Here's a three for Gordon, left side. Weak side rebound. Butler with great position as he out-battled Laxa. Okafor with the catch at the high post. Looks for a teammate. Rifles the pass down low to Butler. Tony DiGregorio, perhaps a very close second. Down low, Mike Hayes is checked in. He's immediately stripped. Butler picks up the loose chain. Four, and there's his 51st turnover. Three on two, Robertson. Closed by Sanders, and Butler is there for the finish. Double figures for the 29th straight game. Mills long three. Here's Butler. Saves it in front of us. Behind the back to Robinson. How did he know he was there?
Speaking of Ernie D.
And Tim Wells calls timeout. There's one for the highlight reel. Now, we'll never know whether Butler knew Robertson was there or he figured, I just have to send it in the general direction of our basket.
Well, you know, either he has the best peripheral vision in the conference or it was just a very opportunistic behind-the-back pass.
Has it knocked away but gets it back. Robertson for three. Long rebound, weak side, Butler for the putback.
The next guy picks him up. There's a rotation by Lang coming out.
Quick step by Robertson, squares up off the back of the iron. Rebound underneath, and the putback is dropped in by Butler. So tough on the boards.
So down the floor before you can set up.
Hills did a good job back on defense. Three blue jerseys around the basket, but the putback by Butler. So strong on the offensive boards. Too wide, maybe.
Oh, great play. Get it out by Williams.
Three on three. Butler floater and hits. Right now.
That's why Carolina will extend, as you can see right now. They're extending a little bit with Johnson out front.
Nice feed baseline. Butler got loose for his 10th point and double figures.
Scoring bunches if you let them go up and down. Here they come again. They're going to push every opportunity.
Okafor got the steal. Gordon controls it. Rolls it, and the tip goes down.
Now Butler's right down the middle with a floor following. This is a real good timeout by Matt Doherty. This is what he feared. The Huskies have awakened.
Butler with the dozen.
You're getting good looks. Keep telling yourself, even if it's not going in, you're getting good looks, so you're doing something right. Whoa!
Brown rejected, but on the backside, it didn't block out, and another easy two for Caron Butler. Now on the game clock, the feet inside, burst sticker, jump hook wouldn't go. And yet another rebound for UConn. Selvey had it for the Huskies. And quickly the transition, the shot, counted! Butler! And we'll go to the free throw line.
Did he ever use the clock well also?
For UConn. Crowd wanted a whistle. Brown to Butler. Swings it around and drains it.
They look pretty comfortable on the floor right now, don't they?
Man, in rhythm.
Yeah, they really try to attack off the dribble as much as possible.
Gordon to Butler. Squares up, shoots over Johnson, cashes it in.
Just like in the first half, you can sense the confidence.
Inside to try to go to Butler. Loose ball still between through three blue jerseys. Able to get his 20-58-42. UConn making a statement.
There we go again. Showtime. Yep, you got it.
Hang on. Buckle up.
When they get it going, they've basically put Carolina away here. I mean, it's just explosive. They don't let up defensively. Hard to believe that this team, the Huskies, did not show up really to get ready to play basketball until the 10-minute mark of the first half.
27 points for Caron Butler. Up and down he goes. Good effort by Melendez. Brown, Butler, baseline.
They just keep coming at you. There's not a whole lot you can do except make some
open. January 27, 1990. The Huskies won that one.
Were you there?
Yes, I was. Caron Butler hits the pull-up right side jump. He'll defend Gordon on this possession.
Van Gorder, not a great defensive player, but likes to shoot.
Butler down low, uses his size advantage over Gordon. 25th of the season. Gordon spins away from Glover. Selby, left side jumper. And Butler with the putback.
Maybe a time for a timeout for St. John's.
It was. And interestingly enough, Mike Jarvis, the second, Mike's son, suggested to Dad, what do you think about calling a timeout here? And Dad said, you betcha.
His comfort level for him to be in this long and to be scoring this many points.
Shot clock at 10. Gordon feeds Butler in the low post. Butler now with 10, so he's in double figures for the 31st consecutive game.
Shelby's pass threaded through. Gordon. Butler! Well, there's no question he is a terrific finisher. Jason Gardner, leading scorer in the Pac-10, has his first points of the game. Butler at the other end.
Terrific job by Butler.
Oh, amazing, isn't it?
Inside to Butler, and that's his power move, and the lead goal scorers today.
Same number of points he had against North Carolina.
Butler, the leading scorer for UConn with the ball now, is only a sophomore over Walton. And Caron Butler.
I think they remember last year's ball game.
Gardner, who had trouble scoring in the first half, has 19 now to lead all scorers. And Caron Butler, the top scorer for UConn, answers. Seconds to go, trailing by a basket. 91-89. Ben Gordon, the freshman, he's got the three-point range. The number one scorer is Butler. He works it inside and ties it up. Caron Butler, it's 91 all. 2:45 to go. 8 on the shot clock as Walton. Away by Caron Butler. 3-on-2. What a pass!
Beautiful.
He just snatched it back in. It's like a vacuum cleaner.
I thought that was going to be Rutgers ball. To least Brown. Caron Butler, quick turnarounds. Got it. Caron Butler. Almost 19 a game for the sophomore. Oh,
beautiful. Oh, the four with a block. Another one. Here's Connecticut. 2-on-1. Again. 3-on-1. Selby. Lost the layup.
Here's Caron Butler, puts it up and in.
Is Okafor ever showing quick feet and reaction?
And Kent for Rutgers. Shot clock at 10 as Luke Brown fires over the top, and an easy one on a putback by Caron Butler. Against St. John's.
Well, he had 63 coming into this game here. He's popped that up to 70.
Oh, good power move by Caron Butler.
This is an obviously Selby wants to go with his left.
Caron Butler gets the layup. Nice inbounds passing. Harassing defense right now. Down low, Butler. Rutgers fans calling for a walk on Gordon. They don't get it.
May have had a little skip there.
Butler against Sherrod. Sherrod
making him work, though.
There sure is. Butler, they harass him. He got the shot. Oh, that's an All-American play. Outstanding work by Caron Butler.
Just a freshman having a terrific year. Jumper from the corner, and there's Butler knocking down a three.
I mean, for the game, George
loves to shoot it from outside, threw it away. Robertson, look ahead for Butler.
He can finish with the best of them. You get him in the open floor with those puppies, and that is something.
So don't throw it away. Give it an effort for 20.
Number three on Kaba. Butler over Anron. Boy, Caron Butler looks like he can take Chris Anron anytime he wants to.
Well, you know, when George Blaney got there, has wild up. The new building coming up. Things are exciting in the Steel City.
They break the press, and a strong finish from Butler.
Now, that's the way to draw it up on the sideline, just like I told you.
Trying to figure out, of all those bubble teams, which league is going to get the bids.
You know, Rutgers has a lot of quality wins, too, now. I mean, against teams that were ranked, so they didn't keep it up with those shoes there of the dive to the 10.
Well, look at Rutgers.
And by the way, Buchanan up, they need him on the floor. Different team without him.
Here is Butler. How about that attack?
A good movement to the back.
To a five-point advantage, and Brown throws up an air ball or a pass to Butler. And Butler in the right spot. Shot. Okafor the rebound. Gordon gonna go with Brown and Gordon. No, Butler finishes.
Something big is usually Caron Butler. That's why running the floor pays off. And unfortunately for Villanova, a dump down to right. They may have had some strength going to the rim. But Jimmy Calhoun now starting to feel a little bit better with the ability to run the floor. And right here, I just think he got the dump in inside.
And then the push
at the other end.
And Butler, who's in the back of
this, just did not give up on the play. Here he comes into the picture, Mike, and that's what makes big-time wins and big-time players. Usually Gordon would convert that. The big guys would stay back at half court. But Caron Butler with the cleanup and the rearrangement. He's taking a lot of hits and licks.
Looked like their NCAA hopes were diminishing, but they have responded well and won their last two.
Right back the other way, a Player of the Year candidate. Caron Butler, a
good job of not giving any easy shots.
Beautifully done. Go down low and Agbaye gets an inside shot. Right back the other way. Caron Butler fires. No one in the country earlier in the year, but look at this. Right back the other way comes the number one three-point shooter for BC. And Kenny Wall's long-distance hit. The Eagles are pretty close to it. 89% free throws. As most great scorers are, good from the line. Now, Caron Butler comes outside and didn't see him. Lead down low. Saw him that time. Caron Butler gets it down. And the lead is cut to six. 17 points for Butler.
Here we go.
Ryan Sidney going all the way down. He's rejected. Rebound knocked around. It'll be a hell. No, it will not be. Okafor picks it up. No timeouts. Robertson's open. Khalid Brown dishes off. Down low. And the Huskies put it up and down with 9 seconds left and take the lead. An unbelievable comeback.
Team of the conference. Connecticut is third. From the baseline, Caron Butler with a 10-footer.
Don't let praise his value to his team. That's a phrase we're going to hear Mr. Elmore use a little bit later on in the telecast again tonight. Butler again. The week continues, presented by AT&T Long Distance. Dan Shulman, Len Elmore with you here at Washington. Caron Butler for three.
Late getting over to cover him. Now Brown to Gordon. Tough bounce pass inside and a strong finish for Caron Butler.
Well, we've seen him shoot outside, we've seen him shoot mid-range, and now we've seen him do damage down low. That's what we talk about when we talk about Caron Butler. Whatever you need offensively, he's capable of giving. And right there, good strong opens up in kind of a 1-3-1 zone. Looks like a 1-2-1-2-1.
Doesn't help him on the first possession as Butler knocks down a three. Now twice all season. Remarkable for a freshman who blocks shots like he does. The guy Jim Calhoun thinks warrants consideration not only for Rookie of the Year, but Defensive Player of the Year as well. And how about this guy, Caron Butler? What about just plain old Player of the Year in the Big East Conference?
Well, there's probably not a better go-to guy in the conference than Caron Butler. You know, when it's money time, his team looks for him, and he uses
for tournament purposes, the Hoyas really only 14-9 because one of their wins was over Division II Marymount. And inside, triple team, left it short. Here comes Gordon, off to Butler, having a huge night. No foul call on Braswell, but Butler scores, and it's 23 points tonight.
Shafino spun right into trouble. In that kind of a year for West Virginia, here's Selby. Selby to Caron Butler. He made a heck of a catch. That's a heck of a catch because that pass was offline.
There, he's got that kind of capability. That's a little early in the shot clock.
Butler tees it up. Three ball for Caron Butler.
I don't think he left us questioning that long-range ability, but he is a pack.
All the West Virginia coaches, oh, there's an easy one. They slipped that. That worked very effectively at Notre Dame. Assistant here. Too bad he didn't have a leash. Air ball, rebounded, running. Here's Connecticut. Look out!
Oh, my.
Pretty good defense here by West Virginia. Brown along the baseline. You hear the West Virginia staff calling for 3 seconds as Caron Butler gets a jump up.
So Leek Brown doesn't get over the top quickly enough.
Butler gets the pick. He raises up and he hits. Boy, that was easy. You don't defend him.
No.
That's what happened.
Yeah, you can't fade behind a trace from the gap and another shooter, so Robertson gets in.
Good denial by Okafor leads to this. Caron Butler with the left hand.
Uncontested shots.
Caron Butler with Selby, Robertson, Okafor.
Oh, sweet. He's so smooth.
He is outstanding.
Speculation and all.
It's Connecticut. Tony Robertson rips it away. A little bit more 1-2, folks. Here's Caron Butler again. Butler scored. Knocked away. when Butler in, boy, it's been that kind of day for Connecticut. Every loose ball. Then with 10 points, 4-5 shooting. Alley-oop attempt.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Picked off. Justin Brown. Justin Brown's got it again. Nice pass. Butler reverse. May want to get him out of there. This game is getting
when out. Brown's out, Gordon plays the point. And I think Ben's more natural at two. Butler on the take and a circus make. Fortunate too. Right by over Okafor, but you see Emeka pushed him away. Butler on the sprint. Soaring dunk. Need refreshing of the storyline as Robertson can't get it to go. Butler puts it back in. Good job, guys. Eric Posner with us as well. And our entire crew does a great job. We all look forward to getting together in New York for the tournament next week. Nothing going on offensively. Six to shoot. Robertson created space. Butler got the rebound. And again! And again! His 12th 20-win season in 16 seasons at Connecticut. Talk about appreciation. I don't know if the folks in Connecticut remember the state of their program.
Butler, he's also left wide open. A baseline jump shot for Caron Butler, averaging almost a 6 point. But that's a dimension of his game you don't see often, him putting it on the floor. Branwell, Okafor never left the floor that time. He starts the break, though, Butler. The run out. Well, I told you how important that outlet pass is off the rim.
You saw a team that was lethargic because they weren't playing with that edge.
Shot clock running down to Leek Brown off the glass, but Butler fouls. Ty Shine hits another three-pointer. He's got 9 in the game now. Butler!
See, you can't sweep on UConn.
Nice. They got the people out of their seats here in Grandpa.
Well, it gives them a chance to exercise those lungs. I don't think they really thought that they would have to cheer this hard this evening.
Caron Butler.
Connecticut in Philadelphia by 5. Butler on sale. Sweet spin move. The average is nearly 20 a game. Sullivan, who is the defensive stopper for Villanova, tries to guard Butler here tonight. He's done a good job on some of the big names that Villanova's played this year. But there's no stopping that. Butler now has 5, and Husky now.
Caron Butler just showing off right now behind the back step back. He's here often during the regular season. Back out here tonight, the Garden will fill up for the Johnnies, as always. After the Villanova turnover, Butler gets it to go with a foul.
He was so strong on that baseline.
Caron over by 2. Gordon comes across the lane, and Wright was guarding Butler. How nifty is coming.
Losing to St. John's. Well squared 54. Until Caron Butler gets the points 11 and 12 on the night. His 5th field goal. And the Huskies back on top.
And now Ryan, 14 and a half a game, gets going. Butler! Steve Fisher, the coach at San Diego State, is trying to get to the title game tomorrow. That's a Butler 2. Put the Huskies on top. Ireland's leading 11-10. And look at the ball movement. Look at the two guys at the top of the cone as time goes on. That's going to open up the Talik Brown situation as one that's rectifiable. Butler for the 5-point Husky lead. Looks so smooth shooting tonight. 13. Not too many analysts to do. If you don't have anything, you got to create for yourself and for your teammates. That's the 13th lead change of the night. That's the 14th lead change of the night. Madison Square Garden. UConn trying to get to the title game one more time. Butler is trying to single-handedly make sure he gets a shot at the title of the Big East. 18 points for the co-player of the year in the conference. The games no one forgets. And again, the early appearance by Brown. Give him a little confidence. He can be helpful. Everybody knew Butler was coming. Nobody could stop it.
But it certainly works to the Husky benefit.
Johnson drawing the defensive assignment. Third different player to guard Butler, who says, "Hi, nice to see you. I'm the conference player of the year."
Okafor said no. Brown lost it, but it found Butler. Ron Butler has that knack. Robertson, 4-3. Butler got it.
Ron Butler.
11-4 Karan, a very educated and intelligent young man. Page lost his shoe. A nice dribble by Butler. Bigger finish, man. A pro finish. May prove to be prophetic. And the Panthers stop it here.
Because they will go after it wherever it might be. But to go to that point, Mike, it's all about understanding how to win regardless of what you're playing for.
Tough turnaround shot by Butler. Robertson on the glass, little UConn push. Butler on the wing, tries to close himself.
Technically, they're sound, but you know this is going to be a game of instincts. You got to have point guard instincts to create when a defense takes something from you.
Butler, who did not do much in the open,
the winning shot.
Huskies run the weave. Take some time. Maybe set up Butler off a bump here. He has it in his hands a little quicker. 8 to shoot. Got to make something happen. Lost the handle. He spun, but collected and connected.
Going around him. Hairston put
on the
line.
On the arm.
No call. Gets it back. Second try. No call again. Gordon blocked it.
He might have got fouled on both of those shots. That's Gordon not being able to pick it up.
Second one for sure. Butler driving underneath.
What a spin move.
Rebounds for the team. So he just, it wasn't a matter of lack of ability. He just didn't get playing time.
Lack of minutes. That's Butler again. So smooth. And he influencing that shot.
Exactly. Not a block, but an influence.
Robertson tipped up and in by Butler. Purvis. Tough shot again. They forced it the last three trips. That'll do it.
Game.
Butler dunks for the 10-point lead.
Hampton really got out of what they wanted to do on the offensive end of the floor for the last 2 minutes of this game.
They were able to beat Indiana and move on to the Sweet 16. Robertson. Great Butler rebound. Inside. Yes, gets the roll. Yes, the Huskies back to 98.
Four by going right down the middle. Butler's got size here in Crawford. And on Cheryl, no matter who guards him, in that kind of a matchup.
One of the best jump shooters in the college. Stolen away, Gordon.
That was Okafor who made the play.
Gordon, nope. And underneath the putback by Butler.
Good solid run, Jim. It hasn't been just any kind of shooting. It's just been good solid offensive play in the half court set.
Butler spin move, 14 point run by UConn.
And really too good a player for the man guarding him in Hodge, who's an outstanding freshman, but no match for Butler.
Timeout, North Carolina State. The Huskies have an 11-point lead. Full court pressure easily broken by Gordon. Off and running over to Butler for two more.
Well, it is money in the bank when you get that ball. And Ron Butler, respect Melvin's outside shooting ability.
Robertson on the run to the corner. In the paint, Butler so tough. Delivers again.
Right, Miller gave up his body. Game getting tight, Jim.
This is a group at UConn that Butler takes the
three. Oh, wow. Huge shot.
One thing Jim Calhoun told us when he came here for the
against the Terrapin, 24 points, 8 rebounds, 4 assists.
Brown to Butler, and one. Chance for the three-point play, matched at the other end.
Whoever talked to Brown after that sequence in the first half where he was turning it over to press. Look at now, he gets that three dribbles, hits ahead to the open man, breaks down the press. Earlier today, he was trying to
last six. The cut at the four, 2:40 remaining.
Crawford on Butler, that's a tough shot, and he makes it anyway.
Wow, Karan Butler.
Boy, Crawford had him.
Straight wins, the Huskies 11.
And Jim, the Big 12 with a third of the field coming from their conference of what's left.
Butler on the inside.
Good move by Jim Calhoun. But Roberts really doing a great job moving his feet instead of trying to hold him off with his hands.
There he is, Karan Butler with a three-pointer.
You'd like to set a double screen for him, but it's not going to be.
Hairston's three down and out. Snap pass up to Butler. Perfect pass. and a foul called on Hairston.
Both teams doing a bad job with defensive balance. Hairston took that jump shot, and Butler just watches. He takes the jump shot and looks. Now the release takes place. You have got to come back and get ready. Now that really should have been Williams's responsibility. His teammate took the shot.
Southern Illinois hit only 1 out of 12 from three.
Great double down by Selby.
Selby read it. Butler able to get free from Hairston. Back to Butler from Okafor. Great passing by the Huskies.
You gotta be thinking Butler to finish this last 10 seconds off.
Gordon to Butler, left and open for the basket.
And see, there's that missed foul shot.
Gordon.
There he was again, almost picking one off.
Robertson three. And Wilcox tips it. Butler in the right spot for UConn.
Gordon will have to really be aware of it. Pretty good size matchup here. Mouton on Butler, but Butler has been outstanding with turnaround 2-2. Now they showed this against Kentucky and did a good job with him. That was a bad technique on that shot.
But inside, Butler with the putback. Battling hard.
His opponents is the Big East best, 37% on the year. Maryland shooting 55, almost 56%. Maryland staying in that zone, figuring it worked very effectively, but that was with Butler on the bench.
Butler banks home a three.
The one
field goal percentage three straight years, rebounds three straight years, leading him tonight. Butler with another three, trying to keep the Huskies' hopes going here in the second half.
Maryland playing more zone than they probably had all year long.
Butler over Holden.
There's the medium range jump shot. We've seen the three, we've seen the drive to the basket, and we've seen the medium range. Jim Calhoun has to like what he's seeing right now. This team, as I pointed out, pretty good at second half comebacks.
Butler for the lead. Huskies in front, 54-53.
Mouton didn't challenge the jump shot. Butler said he wants to put this team on his back and carry him to be the recipient of passes.
Blocked away. And here come the Huskies with a 4-on-2. Brown, Butler.
Double punt.
23rd lead change.
And the final four is set, Jim.
Final 14 seconds. In a thriller here in Syracuse.
Oh,
Butler with
that
a big
Butler
time dunk with 9 seconds.